Welcome back to the live action from this Shanghai GP of the 2018 UIM XCAT World Championship. It's Sunday, it's day of the second race here from Shanghai, China. We are in the Pudong province on the Dingzhou Lake. It's the largest artificial lake with fresh water in China. And as you can see, we are live at the moment. There's all the boats on the docks ready to leave the pontoon and start the race. There's been huge changes compared to yesterday in terms of the results of the race. There's been protests, there's been penalties. So the officers have been working a lot yesterday till late in the night and this morning. They analyzed all the images, all the recordings of the race, all the logs from the telemetry, from the timing, and in the end, there's been a complete shake of the overall results. So now the situation is that race one yesterday on Saturday, the winners were Abu Dhabi 5, followed by Team Australia and followed by Abu Dhabi 4. So a complete change, because yesterday we had the podium, but then it's been completely modified. Now we are here, 11 boats out of 12 are already here. And we're gonna just move around and see if you can catch some emotions, some feelings, and some ideas about this race. For instance, we start here. We have 222 offshore. Giovanni Carpitella is here. Giovanni Joaquin Kumlin as well. We are live now. So in the end, we've seen many changes in the overall results of the race yesterday. You will start in 8th position, if I'm not wrong. Is it correct? Eight. Yeah. So it's going to be a tough start.
Yeah, really tough, because yesterday they penalized us for the restart. We overtake him before the start finish line, boat number two, the Swedish team. So in the end, we try to stay with the number four, but we have an accident together with him and we lose another 2 places. So in the end, unfortunately, we start in 8th, the last of the second gate. And of course, we try to have, as usual, a good start. And we see if we can take a 2-3 position.
Normally you're quite fast in starting.
Yes, yesterday it was very fast. Unfortunately, the last 700-800 meters, we have an alarm, a temperature alarm in one engine. So we lose 7-8 miles and then the other boat arrive. If you don't have the alarm, we turn first. We try today to do this.
Okay, good luck. Have a safe race. Thank you, Giovanni. Thank you, Joachim. Have a safe race. Then we move again. This is one of the disappointments of the new ranking, because they were on the podium yesterday. We have François Pinelli and Giuseppe Schiano. We saw them on the podium. But then François, in English, but you know every language in the world, it's been a disappointment today to read that in the end you finished 6th and not 3rd.
No, I'm always happy, you know. It's a life. It's a race. The restarts is like this. You never know exactly what's happened. Sometimes you win the position, sometimes you lose a position, and it's a life. Today we do better, perhaps.
You're confident that yesterday you did the best that you could, you had a very clean and neat race. Today the conditions are different, you think? A bit more wind?
For me it's better. I know my boat, when there is wind, is better. But we see. After the race I can say it to you.
What's okay, thank you, François. Have a safe race. We say hi also to Saul Bubacco, the third driver of boat number 96. Thank you. Here we have boat number 20. The drivers are already in the cockpit. If I may step on the boat, we have already in the cockpit Serafino Barlesi and Nico Calderola. In the end, you did 4th, the final result of yesterday's race, so you were satisfied.
Sì, sì, certo, siamo stati soddisfatti del risultato di ieri. Poteva andare peggio e poteva andare meglio. Comunque una bella gara.
Perfect. He said we are satisfied. It could have been worse. It could have been better. But anyway, it was a nice race. They're getting ready. I leave them concentrating. They have the two crew of their team helping them. And so, yeah, you couldn't see him, but we actually dove into the cockpit just to give you the idea. They're getting ready. In some minutes, they will all leave the pontoons. Here we have Rosario Amato on board number 46. Andrea Comello is not here, he will be around in some minutes for sure. Rosario, so you're getting concentrated to start the race. If you want to even step down, you don't want to leave your boat.
Oh, okay.
Let's turn this way, then we have the camera there. Yeah.
Where is?
On top.
Ah, oh, sorry. Yeah, we are so happy. I am so happy because I stay with youngest pilot like me, Andrea Comello. And yeah, I'm concentrated. I'm quiet. I'm quiet because for me are the first steps, and I need to make a learn, no, for the boat, for confidential about my colleague in my boat. Yeah, I'm happy. I'm happy. And we start today in a strong position because yesterday happened something on the race about some penalties, some long laps, stopped the race for crash, and we are today in fifth position. And I know that is very difficult, but okay, we try to do the better, the best, okay. Sorry.
Thank you, Rosario. Have a safe race. This is his brother,
yeah, Giuseppe Rosario. Fight with me, yes, today, and in the CF5 position.
Yeah. Yes, fifth and sixth.
Yeah. Exactly. We will see the two brothers into different
boats, number
46
and
96, that will be close together. It will be a family business. So good luck to both of you. Have a safe race. And as Rosario was saying, it's been really a messy race. That's why everything changed. Even during the commentary yesterday, it was difficult to understand. We told you that the commissioners and the UIM people had to work all night in order to realize what was the real actual final result of the race. Here we have boat number 17, Kuwait. We read the name Abdulatif Alomani. He's the owner and the throttleman of the boat. He's not around here. He's probably chatting with other. Yeah, we see them. He's getting an interview in front of us. It's nice also because in these moments you see a lot of drivers from different boats talking each other. Of course, everybody has their own secrets, but they like to talk each other and confront their ideas about the way to take that turn and about the propellers without revealing the secrets, of course. But it's a nice moment of like sharing of ideas. We go on. This is the two boats of Abu Dhabi, number 4 and number 5. We can stop, for instance, here, Sean Torrente. Sean, we are live. The camera is over there on top of the bridge. So, in the end, you stepped down one position from second to third. It was the final decision of the commissioners today.
Maybe not. We haven't started the next race yet. So it could change again. We don't know.
Okay, yeah. He's saying until the beginning of next race, you still don't know what's the final result. Anyway, you will start third today. Yeah. What do you think about the start? What will you think you're doing?
Well, honestly, the one part of my race yesterday I was not happy with was my start. I didn't do a very good job. So today we try to improve that. We did some testing this morning for that. And then me and Fala talked for the race. Once we were in the race, we were very good. We were very fast. We passed many boats. So I'm really happy with the setup. The wind changed a little bit today. So we want more wind. We have a really good setup for that. So, but we'll see. You know, as you saw yesterday, a lot changes. You have a plan, and then everything changes. So,
exactly.
So we'll see today what happens.
Okay. Thank you. Have a safe race. And good luck. I'm gonna try and step on top of boat number 4 and reach boat number 5. Guys, the camera is over there, but I want to. First of all, to congratulate with you because you are the winners of yesterday's race. You got the checkered flag first, then they said no, you are fourth, and now you are first. So you will start first. So who wants to tell me something about the start of today? You will start in first position.
Yes, we'll start in first, and we'll try hard to keep in our position first, and we're trying to also get more points. We're focusing to get more points because we want the world championship.
Yeah. A good opportunity is because also Dubai Police, who is leading the championship, they will start in 11th position. So will you take also an eye on them during the race to realize what they're doing, or you just focus on your race?
I'll focus on my race, always the straight. My point, this race, I forget my back. I'll focus only in the front.
Okay, good luck guys, congratulations for your victory and have a safe race. You realized also from the words that once they are into the cockpit, they don't think to anything else but racing. I remember another driver from another power boating category, he used to say, the only moment I relax is when I step into the cockpit and I fasten my seatbelt, because I don't think to anything else and that's relaxing for me. Even if your adrenaline is pumping and you're thinking about going fast, but that's the best way to relax. Here we go, if I may step on the boat 1 second. We are live, guys. Hello, Jan, hello, Paul. The camera is over there on top of the bridge. So in the end, you celebrated the victory yesterday, but today the final result said you were second. Bit of disappointment.
Yeah, for sure, but we don't look back. I mean, it's nothing we can do, so we just focus on this race and we will try to be on top today.
Yeah,
it's going to be tough, but...
I was thinking one of the opportunities today is given by the fact that Dubai police will start so back. I was asking also to Abu Dhabi number 5, will you take an eye on the Dubai police boat in order to do your race, or you just focus on your one?
I think we just focus on what's ahead of us and don't look back, because it's enough to keep calm and maybe concentrate on that, and also think a little bit about the championship to get some points, and it's really important to complete every race, so that's probably the main thing.
Thank you, good luck, have a safe race. Yeah, we got the same idea from Paul Virik Nielsen. You need to focus on the race and to stay concentrated. Meanwhile, if I may, while we say hi to Dmitry Vandishev, good luck, have a safe race. To you and Mikhail Kiteshev, who is here. Good luck, Misha, have a safe race. Here we have boat number 22, I don't know if the camera can reach it. We saw them yesterday flipping over, we saw them this morning fixing the boat. We will have also a clip of the crash and of the fixing of the boat that we will show you in some minutes. We are happy to see that they are in the water. We are glad to see them take part. They will start from last position, of course, but it's a very good thing for the sport, the fact that they can be here. Now, I try to step on the boat and have a word from Dani Martignoni. I know you're working. No, too tense? Okay, I leave you working. We see Alfredo is already in the cockpit. Okay, good luck. Yeah. That's important. You see, the concentration in this moment is the first thing. Then, you think the camera can reach a bit farther? We try, because on this corner, while we hear the engines roaring, very noisy, on this corner, if the camera can see me, this is Dubai Police. They are the leaders of the championship, of course, Arif Al-Zafei Nadir Bin Indi. They will start in 11th position because they had to retire yesterday because they lost a propeller in the water. So it's a really tough race for them. Let's see if we can have just one word from Arif. I step on your boat. Pardon me. Hello, Nadir. Hello, Arif. You are leaders of the championship, of course, but you start in 11th position, so it's going to be a tough race for you.
Actually, we have problem with my engine. Maybe it's not our day yesterday. We try yesterday night to fix our problem, and we start today 11th position, and we'll try important for us to get some point this race.
Yeah. Okay, I leave you because I heard the whistle blowing. It means that you have to go in the cockpit. Good luck and have a safe race to you both. Thank you. So you heard the whistle blowing. Maybe you didn't hear it, but there's the white flag. This means all the drivers had to get into the cockpits. It's normally given when all the boats are ready at the pontoon. They will have to get into the cockpit, and in 5 minutes they will leave the pontoon. Can we have just one very quick word, if the camera can turn? No, okay, yeah, if you can come here, we have the live camera, we are live here. Is it okay here? We are with the team manager of Sueca 13, Josephine Dubois. So, so far, a bit of disappointment because you know the performance that your guys and your boat can give.
Yeah. We try our best. We have switched all the electricity in the boat for the last 2 days, and yesterday was a little chaotic in the race, but we hopefully will be better today.
Okay, and thank you.
Thank you.
Have a safe race. Okay, so I think it's over. We spoke with all of them. Now we see the last preparations. You see all of them getting in the cockpit. This is the moments they fasten, they tighten their seat belts. They check all the electronics, then they start the engines. You can't hear probably, but it's really roaring all around here. This, yeah, another boat starting the engines. It's like 800 horsepower for each boat. We move again a little bit in this direction and see what happens. You see also Team Australia getting ready. The cockpit of this boat is really narrow. They just have barely the space to move. but the first point is the size of the canopy on top and the hatch on the bottom, because safety is the first concern, of course. In case of any kind of accident of crash, they are able to leave the cockpit in a matter of seconds. These engines are starting. Maybe you can see the bubbles, the sprays going out. A bit of acceleration to test. Now it's in neutral, of course. In some minutes, the commissioner who's on top of the bridge will give the yellow flag, the green flag, pardon me. That first green flag will mean all boats leave the pontoon and start to move outside to the race course. The lake is around the corner on my left, and then they will get into position, aligned, going out. And after some other minutes, they will have the yellow flag. Yellow flag means speed up a bit, 20-25 knots, and then when they are in the back of the circuit, the far part, all of a sudden they will have the green flag, that means full throttle, and the race will start. Let me check the time. Yeah, we are almost there. Now, I think we can see a clip with all the action from yesterday. We have also the images, nice images of the crash of boat 22. We know the drivers are safe, unarmed, and the boat is already in the water. It will take part into this race. So let's watch this clip with yesterday's action, the crash, and then we go back live. We will have the live streaming of race 2 in some minutes here from Shanghai. We will comment with you on a Facebook page. So if you can write any question you have, you write and we will follow up with you. Thank you so much and stay tuned.
我们所有的摩托艇将会从这里由我们的一号摩托艇来进行带领进入到我们整个赛场。 好的，李佳老师，现在可以给我们一点音乐，我们的比赛即将开始。
是我们的一号摩托艇，那据了解呢，它主要是起一个引领作用。坐在这一上面的是我们的航程裁判，在这样一个比赛规则当中，我们是由航程裁判把我们所有的摩托艇引到我们出发边去，以及还在现场熟悉我们整个的这样一个赛道。在我们的一号引擎指出我们整个赛道之后，我们所有的比赛。 从这个角度来看，所有的摩托艇现在已经是来到了出发的位置，正在进行整顿。 刚刚有视频朋友在跟我交流的过程当中，有说为什么我们整个的这个时间烧成飞驰？其实大家现在眼界为实啊，能够看到我们这个摩托艇它的体积非常的庞大，它的长是12米，宽是3.5米，净重是2吨。所以对于这样的一个摩托艇的操作来说，我们必须有两名赛手来进行操作，一名赛手他负责速度，另外一名赛手负责我们的方向。
接下来出赛第一列的是，好的，阿布蒙古队，叫阿布蒙古队， 到最后，在赛场之上，除了看第一、第二位。 另外一位是达伦·林特尔森，那我们的一号赛手啊，他的这个赛事经验是相当的完爆，一共是有了六个。 应该 Thank you. Thank you. 加油！ 水上表演现在开始。来，于翔老师，声音稍稍开大一些。现在大家看到的是我们四乘六的这样的一个国旗的展示，在我们两位护旗手的衬托之下，我们新定的五星红旗迎风飘扬，在我们这一片水域之上显得更加的灿烂夺目。来，医生老师，不要卡，不要怕，这个音乐把我的声音盖过，我们的音乐声音可以再大一些。亲爱的朋友们，让我们向国旗致敬，向我们在表演场地的这些运动健儿加油助威，掌声送给他们。当这个国旗飘飘起的话，就是有两名运动员在滑雪过程当中通过滑雪梯。
Here we have Sean Torrente, we see, and then all of them, they're really happy. First and second position, the four drivers from UAE, from Abu Dhabi in particular, celebrating. Here is Faleh Al-Mansouri taking a selfie with his team. You see, he won the race. It's great to see all this team, really a massive show of strength for them. Good victory that takes them very close to the top.
Powerboat team in the world, Abu Dhabi. You see this?
It say it again.
Is the best powerboat team in the world. Okay, I'm sorry.
I believe it's true.
We race Formula One also, and we have an amazing team there. And we come here and have a one and two, and we're so blessed to be able to do this with everybody. They have a great crew, and it's our pleasure to drive the boat they prepare.
I can really tell, Sean, that you're really feeling emotional now. Thinking back about the race, can you tell something about how did it go?
Listen, we get a great start, and we were right on our teammates, and we were actually able to push them, and we knew we were faster. We honestly just beg our radio man, when can we take the long lap so we can be clear? And as soon as we took that, we just calmed down, made good laps, and we knew we were faster, and when they take their second long, we were ahead, when we knew it. And then from there, it was just managing the race and making sure we didn't take any risk after we got a good lead. Like I said, for a 1-2 finish, for us it doesn't matter, we're one team, it doesn't matter which order.
Has there been any moment when you thought you could lose the leadership to your teammates or to 96? Actually, you did for a while, but it was just a matter of long laps, but
correct.
In general?
No, we knew we were in good shape. Honestly, the last five laps were so painful because you have a good lead and everything is good, you're just waiting for something to go wrong, you know? So you just try to maintain the mind and stay focused one lap at a time, stay away from the buoy. But no, we knew if we did our job, we were good.
Congratulations again. Great. And so we heard from Sean. He was really emotional, actually. I could tell by standing beside him. And it's also good to see how they are close together. They say it doesn't matter who wins, we are just one team. You saw them celebrating. You see them very happy for this 1-2. We try if we can catch some words also from the other boat, boat number 5, which did the second. We have Faleh Al-Mansouri. You want to tell us something? Thank you. Yeah, so you did the 1-2, second place for you.
I'm very happy for this podium today. Our strategy is very good. Me and both 4 and both 5. We are team 1. We're thinking about the points to increase each boat to get the world championship.
Thank you. Congratulations. So yeah, this was the massive show of strength from Team Abu Dhabi, boat number 4, number 5. I look around because I want to find also third place. We had François Pinelli and Giuseppe Schiano. It was an amazing third place for them as well. Let's see, try and follow me if we can find them. You see, there's a lot of curious people now here. For some of them, for most of them, it's the first time they see a show like this and they're really thrilled. We don't see them. I was talking before anyway with Francois, and he said, okay, this is the first weekend in the cockpit with Giuseppe Schiano. Francois is the throttle man and Giuseppe is the driver. And he said, I was sure that my boat was fast, and with Giuseppe we found immediately the best feeling together. And so yesterday in the end, they finished third, they celebrated, but as we told you, everything changed because during the night they had to check back all the penalties and the protests. So in the end it was sixth place for them yesterday. They started in sixth place now, but they finished third. So today it's a real podium, a third place for them. Sorry, I'm emotional as well. And they had a very good start, taking two boats immediately. Then they fought a lot with the fourth, which was Team Australia. In the end, they said a perfect strategy from Saul Bubaku, which is normally the third driver, but also the radio man and the strategist. And so that's what they did. In a minute, I'm sure they will come because they have to celebrate on the podium. Meanwhile, let's see if we can go around and see what happens. Here we have some local girls that will be the hostesses. What is typical every time we race in China, they have this kind of costume uniform. And yeah, we see around. I don't really see them. Maybe they went for a refreshment, some drinks. Let's have a word with Sebastiano, what do you think of this weekend? We are live now, it's ended.
Was really, let's say, amazing, but even hard to work in this new place, because as everybody of us, you know, when you are approaching a new place, you have to start from zero, so you have, before you create a feeling with the local people, and then, as usual, then the second and third day is going smoothly. So China is a big country, we get some experience in the past. Shanghai for us was the first time. It was really hard to understand the system because unfortunately it's not like in the western side. So each city has their proper rules. So even what we learn in the past in the other cities is different here. But anyway, at the end, we perform, I think, a good weekend. We are satisfied. And the place is beautiful, it's perfect for our race.
I remind you, Sebastiano Pelecchia is Sport and Safety Director of the Championship. Just a question, it's a curiosity also for me. If you can remember in how many countries or places you've been organizing races in your career?
Apart Africa, I think we were everywhere. And this is because I am old. And each time I remember how many countries we visit, I remember that time is gone and my age is gone.
Still very fit and still perfect in organizing. Thank you, really. Thank you. Without the work of Sebastiano, we won't be here.
Thank you.
Sport and Safety Director Sebastiano Pelecchia, along with Pasquale Cesano, which is the other manager. They organized so many races. And this whole championship, XCAT championship show that you see, is mostly because of them. Meanwhile, the drivers have arrived. Maybe it's too late, we just go there and see. It's too late because they are being called on stage, so just congratulations, we are live, congratulations Giuseppe, we are live. I'm not asking you nothing because you're going on the podium. Great job Francois, we are live there. Yeah, I don't want to disturb them anymore because they've been calling on the podium. So I would say to the people inside, we can go with the images from the other cameras because the drivers are going on stage now.
好的，接下来进行我们隆重的颁奖仪式。 首先颁发的是获得本次大赛的三等奖，请出我们的颁奖嘉宾，上海市浦东新区南汇新城镇体育联盟秘书长程永健，意大利东方蓝色丸有限公司董事长卢山为我们获得本次大赛第三名的选手颁奖。 再一次的恭喜我们的获奖选手，也请我们的颁奖嘉宾和我们的合影留念。接下来颁发的是本次大赛的二等奖，有请我们的颁奖嘉宾，国家体育总局水上运动管理中心五部部长姚新培，上海市浦东新区南汇新城镇社区建设和服务办公室主任朱柔。 为获得二等奖的两名选手颁奖，有请我们的颁奖嘉宾和我们的获奖选手合影留念，谢谢。接下来颁发的是本次大赛的一等奖，有请国家体育总局水上运动管理中心党委书记李瑞麟、支付宝蚂蚁金服董事长景贤栋。 UIM 办公室主任李卡波、拉布涅达为获得一等奖的选手颁奖，有请。亲爱的朋友们，再次响起热烈的掌声，为获得我们冠军的选手表示祝贺。有请我们的颁奖嘉宾和我们的获奖赛手何以留念。
哇！然后，
再一次的恭喜，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢各位颁奖嘉宾，谢谢，谢谢。接下来我们将要颁发的是本次大赛的最佳领队奖，获奖者是快乐阿塞德斯拉夫，恭喜！有请我们的颁奖嘉宾。 阿里体育总裁张大中为我们的这一位最佳领队颁奖。好的，谢谢，请我们所有的颁奖嘉宾来到我们的主席台，可以留念。 来，有请我们工作人员拿出我们的摄像机。好的，再一次的感谢各位。接下来，让我们全场肃立，奏冠军队国歌。 再一次祝贺我们的获奖赛队，好的，我们的嘉宾请一步，谢谢你们，谢谢。来，接下来有请我们的赛事宝贝来到我们的这样的一个合影区，和我们的获奖赛手合影留念，谢谢。来，亲爱的朋友们。
我们本次大赛也圆满结束了，再一次感谢我们的领导和嘉宾对本次大赛的关心支持和帮助，也再一次的感谢各位现场的观众朋友对我们本次大赛的热情的关注，再一次感谢台前幕后所有。